I am so excited for you to meet Alexis. She's 17 years old from Cheatham County. She's been coming to Vanderbilt Children's Hospital for how long?
It's 2017, so 5 years now.
5 years. And what brought you here?
Being diagnosed with an inoperable brain tumor. I started losing eyesight and we figured out, hey, it's a brain tumor, not just needing glasses.
And it really is affecting your vision.
Yes, ma'am. I have lost all my vision in my right eye and I've lost 72% in my left eye.
But you are so incredible because you've not let it stop you from doing anything. I hear you've gone to prom, you're a cheerleader.
Yes.
What other kinds of things?
Also a big sister for the Big Brother, Big Sister program, and I have two younger siblings of my own, and dealing with them every day is lots of fun. I have a sister that's about 16 now, and then I have a little brother that's 12. So.
Great. And tell us how Vanderbilt Children's Hospital has played a part in all of you being able to do all of this.
They have been a wonderful part of everything. I mean, I don't know where I would be at without all their help because, I mean, I would probably be just blind and in my bedroom crying all the time because I couldn't see, but I have wonderful doctors and nurses, so I love my nurses. And I mean, just wonderful support here at Vanderbilt.
That's amazing. So you come back regularly for?
Yes, ma'am. I get an MRI every 3 months and make sure everything's good and stable and no tumor, no cyst, or nothing is growing. So.
That's amazing. What kind of place in your heart does Vanderbilt Children's Hospital hold?
A very big heart. I mean, for sure. It's a big part of my heart because being here so many years and meeting so many wonderful other kids that have gone through chemotherapy and have journeys more bigger than I could ever imagine for myself, and just meeting the absolutely most amazing people to help me also too.
And not only are you amazing, but the doctors and the nurses and everyone here are so amazing. What would you tell the folks who are watching about why it's so important to support a hospital like this?
Well, for sure, for like helping, it's just, we need the help. Like children that have to spend 8 hours doing chemo, you know, they're ready to go home. And, you know, so also having the help and love and support that, hey, somebody else is there helping support, helping you pay for stuff and just like being there with you at all times.
And I know you are really excited because you just finished up classes and you're looking forward to the summer.
Oh, yes, for sure. Lots of camps this summer.
Big plans for the summer.
Oh, yes.
What kind of camps are you doing?
I'm doing FCA camp, which is Fellowship of Christian Athlete. I'm also doing Camp Rainbow, which is a camp for cancer kids and kids with disabilities. So, and it's a fabulous camp. You get one-on-one attention with your counselor, and there's 7 doctors there. And, I mean, it's always like, it feels like you're on top of the world kind of deal.
Awesome. Well, you are on top of the world. Thank you so much for joining us. Help me out with the number. It's 615-322-KIDS. Tell everybody that they should pick up the phone and call. What's the number?
615-322-KIDS.
Call now. Make a donation.
What a brave young lady there. And you're actually going to see a before and after. So she has some amazing hair. And she decided before prom that someone else could use her hair more than she could and volunteered to cut all of it off. She actually says she prefers her shorter hair. So the generosity from dollars to volunteers to locks of hair really continues to be endless here. And of course, for you folks at home too, we want to give some shout outs quickly. Mary Simmons from Smyrna, $100. Mary, thank you so much. Yeah, buddy. Christine in Nashville, $25. Amy in Brentwood, $50. That was a check donation. Thank you so much. And then Carol Wyatt, we want to give a shout out here too, $25. Thank you so much. Every single penny makes such a difference, whether it's $5 or $500.